Hi dear students, in this video I am going to talk about sp3d2 hybridization and sp3d3 hybridization. These two topics are from the chapter chemical bonding and molecular structure. sp3d2 hybridization. One s orbital, plus 3 p orbitals, x, y, z axis, p x orbital, p y orbital, PY orbital plus PZ orbital, Z axis, Y axis, X axis. This is PY orbital, PZ orbital, 1S orbital, 3P orbitals, PX, PY, PZ plus DX square, Y square orbital. This is x axis, y axis, z axis. So for the x square, y square, lobes are along the axis, along the x axis and y axis. This is d x square, y square, and d z square orbital. X axis, y axis, z axis. This is d z square orbital, which has lobes along the z axis, and there is no nodal plane for the dz square orbital. Lobes are along the z axis and there is no nodal plane for the dz square orbital. So total 1 2 3 4 5 6 orbitals are combining. So when these are undergoing hybridization, these will form 6 hybrid orbitals. Geometry will be octahedral. Geometry is octahedral. Hybrid orbitals always indicated with the one big lobe and one small lobe. Right? And remaining orbitals, two orbitals are perpendicular to the plane of the board. Geometry octahedral. 6 orbitals are combining to form 6 equivalent sp3d2 hybridized orbitals. The geometry of the orbitals is octahedral geometry. Example for this is SF6. Now let us discuss the hybridization in sulfur in SF6. SF6, sulfur hexafluoride. Sulfur atomic number 16. Electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. Total number of electrons is 16, right? Outermost shell, it has 6 electrons. So orbital diagram in the ground state for the sulfur, we can write like this. Ground state, orbital diagram, 3s orbital has 2 electrons, 3p subshell has 3 orbitals, 3s which has 2 electrons, and 3p has 4 electrons, 3p has 4 electrons. In the second excited state, this is a ground state electronic configuration. In the second excited state, 3D orbital is present. 3D orbital, earlier it was empty. Subshell, which has 5 orbitals, 3p orbital, 3s orbital. Students, in the ground state configuration for the sulfur is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. Outermost configuration is 3s2, 3p4. So in the first excited state, this electron will jump into one of the 3d orbital. Second excited state, this electron also jump into the 3d orbital, right? Then 3s has one electron. In the second excited state, orbital diagram we can write like this: 3p subshell has 3 electrons, 3d has 2 electrons. Total 6 unpaired electrons are present. 1s orbital, 3p orbitals and 2d orbitals will combine to form 6 equivalent sp3d2 hybrid orbitals. And geometry of the molecule is octahedral. Octa means 8, hedral means faces. So we can write the shape of molecule like this. Sulfur is the central atom, 1 fluorine, like this we can indicate, 2nd fluorine, 3rd fluorine, 4th fluorine, and 1 fluorine is towards observer, towards us, which is perpendicular to the plane of the board. 1 fluorine is into the board like that, right? So with the molecular model we can observe clearly this shape, octahedral shape will be like this. Students, please assume that this green color ball as a sulfur and orange color balls, 6 balls are there, assume it as a fluorines, right? So geometry, it is called as octahedral, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4 in one plane, bottom 4 more faces will get, total 8 faces. So that's why it is called as a octahedral. And the bond angle will get it as 90 degrees. Bond angles are 90 degrees in this, right? So let us take one more example for this sp3d2 hybridization. Students, next example we will take BRFI, interhalogen compound, BRFI. So in this, 5 bond pairs, 1 lone pair is present. 5 bond pairs and 1 lone pair is present, right? Bromine is 17th group element, halogen, 17th group element. It has a 7 valence electrons. When it is making 5 bonds with the 5 fluorine atoms, roughly we can write the structure like this: F, total 5 fluorine atoms are present, and after making 5 bonds with the 5 fluorines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons of bromine is utilized in bond formation. Now it has 1 lone pair. Total number of electrons is 7. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons are used in bond formation. And 2 more electrons which will remain as a lone pair, right? So total bond pairs is 5, lone pair is 1. So single bond always a sigma bond, and hybrid orbitals always forms a sigma bonds. 5 sigma bonds, 1 lone pair. So 6 hybrid orbitals is required, that is in the case of sp3d2 we will get. So hybridization of bromine in this case is sp3d2 hybridization, right? Geometry of the molecule, geometry in the all the cases of sp3d2, if it has a 6 bond pair of electrons, 5 bond pairs, 1 lone pair. If it has 4 bond pairs, 2 lone pairs, all the cases geometry is octahedral. Geometry is octahedral. But shape of the molecule is square pyramidal. Square pyramidal. We can indicate the BRFI structure like this. Five fluorine atoms are indicated like this. Five fluorine atoms. And above this, it has one lone pair of electrons. It has one lone pair of electrons. So due to this lone pair, this will be bent like this. Slightly bent downwards. We can observe from by using this, students. In the SF6 earlier, we have seen all the 6 bond pairs are present. Now what we will do is, for the BRFI structure, simply we will remove one of the ball, right? Now it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bond pairs, 1 lone pair. We know lone pair bond pair repulsion is more than the bond pair repulsions. Then what happens? These bonds will slightly bent like this. Then the geometry which we are getting, that is called as a square pyramidal, slightly bent like this, because of lone pair bond pair repulsion is more effective than the bond pair repulsion. This is more effective. So slightly this will bent downwards. Then whatever the geometry we are getting, that shape, geometry is octahedral, but shape of the molecule is, that is a square pyramidal we are getting. Let us take one more example, XZF4, which has a 4 bond pairs and 2 lone pairs. XZF4, xenon tetrafluoride. Xenon is 18th group element. Xenon is 18th group element. It has 8 valence electrons. 8 valence electrons are present with the xenon, right? So when it is making 4 bonds with the 4 fluorine atoms, 4 bonds with the 4 fluorine atoms, then out of the 8 valence electrons of xenon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4 are utilized in bond formation with the 4 fluorine atoms. Then remaining 4 electrons, it is present in the form of lone pairs. 2 lone pairs of electrons are present with this. So single bond always a sigma bond. Single bond is sigma bond, sigma bond, sigma bond. 4 sigma bonds, 2 lone pairs are present. So 6 hybrid orbitals you will get in the case of sp3d2 hybridization. sp3d2 hybridization. Geometry of the molecule is, including lone pair, we can tell the geometry, that is a octahedral geometry. Octahedral geometry. But shape of the molecule, this we have to omit the lone pairs, then we will get it as a square planar. Shape of the molecule is square planar. Square planar. Students, in the SF6 structure, like this you take SF6 structure. So one is removed. This side I am removing, right? This side also it is removed, right? Then we will get a XZF4 structure is like this, right? So 4 fluorine atoms are present in the same plane along with the xenon. Same plane they are present. And one lone pair is above this plane. One lone pair is below this plane. The shape of the molecule is square planar. Students, we can summarize this sp3d2 hybridization as, six bond pairs, zero lone pairs are present, then shape of the molecule is octahedral. Octahedral, that is SF6 is an example for this. 5 bond pairs, 1 lone pair is present. Then shape of the molecule is square pyramidal. Square pyramidal. And example for this is BrF5. 4 bond pairs, 1 lone pair. Sorry, not 1 lone pair, 2 lone pairs are present. Total we have to get it as 6. Right? Then geometry is octahedral. Shape of the molecule is square planar. Square planar. Students, if it is a D2SP3 hybridization is present. This is not a syllabus of chemical bonding. This is a syllabus of coordination compounds. We have this D2SP3. So then here D orbitals involved are DZ square, DX square, Y square. But these orbitals are inner D orbitals. Inner D orbitals. Students, that means, for example, if it is a 4S orbital, 4PX, 4PY, 4PZ is involved. And the D orbital is 3D X square, Y square, 3D Z square. Then the hybridization will be D2SP3. If all the orbitals are outer orbitals, then the hybridization is SP3D2. If it is 4S, 4PX, 4PY, 4PZ and 4D X square, Y square, 4D Z square, then the hybridization is SP3D2. So we will continue our discussion with the next type of hybridization, that is SP3D3. Students, next type of hybridization is SP3D3 hybridization. SP3D3 hybridization. One S orbital, 3 P orbitals, X axis, Y axis, Z axis. This is PX orbital, 1 S orbital plus 1 PY orbital, X, Y, Z plus PZ orbital. PZ orbital, X axis, Y axis, Z axis, and 3 D orbitals are involved. 3 D orbitals are, this is X axis, Y axis, Z axis. X axis, Y axis, Z axis. Then the lobes are in between the axis. Lobes are in between the axis for the DXY plus X, Z, Y orbital, Y axis, sorry, this is D, X, Z, X, Z orbital, D, X, Z orbital plus X axis, Y, Z orbital, Y, Z orbital. Lobes are in between the Z axis and Y axis. Z axis and Y axis. This is DYZ orbital. 3 orbitals are involved. For these 3 orbitals, lobes are in between the axis. Lobes are in between the X axis and Y axis for the DXY. X axis and Z axis for the DXZ. Y axis and Z axis for the DYZ orbital. Then these will combine to form 7 equivalent SP3D3 hybrid orbitals. SP3D3 hybrid orbitals. Hybrid orbitals. Geometry: pentagonal bipyramidal. Pentagonal bipyramidal. Students, let us take example for this IF7. IF7. Iodine is 17th group element. General outermost electronic configuration is ns2np5. Orbital diagram we can write like this: ns np subshell nd subshell nd subshell. This is a ground state electronic configuration. NS subshell has 2 electrons. NP has 5 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons are present. In the third excited state, students, first excited state means this electron will jump into the nd orbital. One, this second is this will jump into here, and the third excited state is this is also jump into the nd orbital. Now 7 unpaired electrons we will get in this case, right? In the third excited state, ns has 1 electron, np has 3 unpaired electrons. NDS 3 unpaired electrons. 1, 2, 3, right? So 1 s orbital, 3 p orbitals, 3 d orbitals will combine to form 7 sp3 d3 hybridized orbitals. Geometry is pentagonal bipyramidal. Structure we can write like this: iodine, which is bonded with the 5 fluorines. These will lie in the plane of the board. By joining these, we will get pentagon. This is these 5 fluorines and iodine will lie in the plane of the board. 1 fluorine is towards observer. This is perpendicular to this plane of the board. One fluorine is away from the observer. Geometry and shape, it is same, pentagonal bipyramidal. Here 2 angles are possible. Total angle in a circle is 360 divided by 5, which is 72 degrees we will get. And one more angle, these fluorines which are perpendicular to the plane of the board, FIF bond angle, 2 different angles are possible. One is 72 degrees, other one is 90 degrees. Students, this is about the sp3d2 and sp3d3 hybridization. Thanks for watching.